So specifically talking about car camping, I wanted to discuss my essential items that I bring every single year. So starting with the obvious, make sure you do have your wristband and your car camping sticker. Your car camping sticker should already be on your car when you're pulling into security, just so that they know that you are where you need to be. Another essential item that you absolutely do need to bring, if you've seen any pictures of anybody car camping, you've seen that everybody has a canopy or an easy up. So even if you are flying into California, make sure you do hit up a store to go get that. It is very essential because it does provide you with shade. I highly suggest getting a straight leg canopy. They're just way easier to work with. They're way easier to lower before going into the festival, which is highly recommended to do, because if you don't and there's high winds, then your canopy can get very damaged and you do not want that to happen. There have been plenty of weekends where a lot of canopies have been lost because they've flown away. It does happen, so make sure that you do get something to secure that down. If you do need to get a slant leg canopy instead, if that's all that's available, then obviously get that one instead. It's not that big of a deal. I just think the straight leg ones are easier to lower. And if you do only have one car camping spot, then make sure to get a canopy that is 10 feet by 10 feet. Even if you do have multiple camping spots, you're camping with a large group, each person should have a 10 feet by 10 feet canopy because your space is a 10 feet by 30 feet space. They do have canopies available that are 12 feet by 12 feet. Obviously, that'll be a little bit too large for your spot. Now, in order to keep that canopy into the ground, you also need to pick up some plastic stakes. The metal stakes that come with the canopy are not allowed. If security catches you with them, they will confiscate them. Fortunately, at Walmart, they do have these yellow plastic stakes. They do break pretty easily, so do make sure to pick up some extras. While you are purchasing your plastic stakes, it's also really good to pick up a rubber mallet. The rubber mallet will help you get the plastic stakes into the ground, which would be pretty difficult without it. Now, in order to keep those plastic stakes attached to the canopy legs, you are gonna need either zip ties or pre-cut rope, as scissors are not allowed into the festival grounds either. Last year I used zip ties and those actually worked pretty well to keep the canopy attached. You can also use pre-cut rope, which makes it a little bit easier to get it unattached at the end of your trip. Now I also suggest getting sheets or tapestries to attach to your canopy to provide shade for you. Keep in mind the sun rises in the east, so if your campsite is facing the east, as well as the sun setting in the west, so if your campsite's facing that way, then if you are trying to enjoy your time eating dinner or whatever at your campsite or just hanging out, then you will have a lot of sun in your campsite at that time as well. If you're driving to Coachella, then it doesn't hurt to bring more than one sheet, because then you can put shade up on all sides if you want to. Maybe you just want that extra privacy. Now, to attach those sheets to the canopy, I personally like to bring jumbo binder clips. I think they work really, really well. I've used clamps before, and honestly, I think the binder clips work better. You can also use safety pins, just wrap the sheet around and attach it to the other side.
Or you could just safety pin your canopy to the sheet, you know, that works too.
So something else I do suggest bringing are lights for your campsite. A majority of the time that you're at camp will be daylight, but if you do come back to your camp to eat dinner or just to hang out, just take a break, it is a lot nicer to have a light to navigate your campsite. Battery powered fairy lights are a really good option. Just make sure that you bring tape or something to attach it to your easy up or whatever you're attaching it to. So something else I have to bring every single year is my own toilet paper. Nice toilet paper. I'm sure you knew it already, but you are going to be using porta potties throughout the weekend. So it is always nice just to have your own toilet paper that's, you know, 3-ply and not the like 1-ply that they use there. Sometimes they're out of toilet paper, so you just don't have to worry about it. I like to roll up the toilet paper too and bring it into the festival because there's porta potties in there as well. I know like using the porta potties are kind of like a big deal for a lot of people. It's something that kind of turns them off from the idea of car camping, but in all honesty, the porta potties are not that bad. There's a men's side and there's a women's side, and there's gender neutral ones as well. They can get kind of gross, but there's tons of them, so just go to the next one. You're bound to find a clean one. They do clean them throughout the day, they pump them out. So I mean, if that's something you're worried about at car camping, you really don't need to be. It's really not that bad. But like I said, bringing your own toilet paper really helps. And if you want to bring baby wipes with you, that's good. You can even bring Clorox wipes with you. That helps out a lot too. So, I mean, when it comes down to it, there's just ways around it, ways to work with it. So don't let that make or break your decision to go car camping. So something I've recently been bringing past 2 years is a portable shower, just a 5-gallon portable shower. It is probably the best purchase I've made as far as my essential items for Coachella. I love it. Like, I really don't like the showers at Coachella. I just don't like having to walk to them and wait in line. You do have the option of VIP showers too. You could pay $10. I've heard like mixed things about it. I don't know if they're that much better. Obviously, if you're VIP, then you can use it. But if you're not VIP, you can pay the $10 to use it. But I haven't really heard that it's that much better. So I just like to use my own shower. So like I said, I have a 5-gallon shower. I fill it up at the water station. I carry it back in a rolling cart because it is pretty heavy. I set it up on my car. I let it warm up a little bit. And then I take a shower. So there are a few reasons why I don't like the showers. For one, I don't like to wait in the lines. It's just annoying. Two, sometimes they have to close them down because somebody decides to go to the bathroom in the showers. And they have to shut them down and clean them. And there's only one trailer open and there's a long line at 2 o'clock in the morning. And it's not fun. If you do choose to go to the showers, honestly, I think the best time is like 11:30, mainly because it's hot outside, so a nice cool shower feels really, really nice. And there's normally shorter lines at that time. However, one of the years I took a shower at 11:30 and the shower was like clogged. So I was standing in several inches of dirty water. It was not fun. That was the year I decided I'm buying a portable shower. Now, not everybody has had the same experience as I have. Obviously, I've just had really bad luck with it, so I chose to get my own shower. It's just nice to be at my campsite and be able to do that whenever I want to. If you want to take a shower after the festival, then obviously a portable shower is probably not going to be the best idea because it will be pretty chilly and windy at night, so a hot shower probably sounds pretty good at that time. But, I mean, it wouldn't hurt to have one just in case, you know what I'm saying? So moving on, another thing that makes my camping experience that much better is a fan and a spray bottle. If you haven't figured it out already, it can get miserably hot during the day at Coachella. So something I love doing is sitting in my chair. I have a table in front of me with the fan on it. I have my spray bottle filled with water, fans going, and just spray water. And it just feels so nice. You know, it can get really bad, especially if you're not used to it. I live in the Central Valley in California. Like, I'm used to 110 degree weather, but Coachella is something else. I mean, depending on which weekend you go, it can be a couple degree difference, but just plan on it being really, really hot. Something else that's kind of obvious that you most likely will bring is a tent. If you go shopping for one, pay attention to the dimensions. Because like I said before, your space is a 10 feet by 30 feet space. So if your tent is 10 feet on one side, like mine is, it's gonna take up a good chunk of your camping space. Obviously, if you have multiple camping spots, you don't really have to worry about that. But it is a good thing to be aware of if you just have the one spot. You know, even a tent is not really necessary. A lot of people choose to just sleep under their canopies and they're totally fine with that because by 7-8 o'clock in the morning, that sun is shining on your tent and your tent turns into a sauna. It can get very, very hot. You're not gonna be in your tent during the day. You just melt. If you choose not to get a tent, or even if you do have a tent, keep in mind it can get freezing at night. Yes, it's super hot during the day, but at nighttime, it's like the complete opposite. It can be freezing. So make sure you do have lots of blankets and lots of warm clothes, because if you have to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night, it's not a good time. It's not a good time to be wearing shorts and a tank top. Mm-mm. So just make sure that you're prepared for that, because it's not a fun time if you're not prepared. So that about covers my essentials. I will post everything else that I do bring as well. If this is your first time car camping, I hope you have a fantastic time. It is such a great experience. Just remember, be kind to each other, be nice to your neighbors. Go to the silent disco, do all the camping activities in the morning before the festival starts. It's such a fun time. If you have any other questions about Coachella, tips about it, my experiences at Coachella, anything of that nature, please let me know. I'll be happy to make a video about it.
One last thing, make sure to pick up your trash throughout the weekend. When you're in the festival, there's trash cans everywhere, throw your trash away. And then at the end of the festival, when you're packing up for camping, put all of your trash into one trash bag or multiple trash bags. Take to the trash. Don't just leave a giant mess at your campsite. It's disgusting and absurd that people do this. So please just be a decent human being. Thank you.